Welcome to GDs, and this is Absentia Season 1. We start the season with Harlow, a suspected serial killer, being sentenced to life for the murder of FBI agent Emily Byrne. Since her body was never recovered, her husband Nick confronts him, but he walks away. 6 years later, a body is recovered whose eyelids have been removed, and this is exactly the same signature as that of Harlow. Meanwhile, Nick has remarried, and Alice is taking good care of Lynn, Emily's and Nick's son. One night, Nick gets a call, and it's Harlow, who lets him know that his wife is still alive and he has an hour to save her. As Nick reaches the location, Emily is trapped inside a glass box, and Nick saves her from drowning. When Emily wakes up, she has no memory of the time she was away, and she is surprised to learn that 6 years have passed. Harlow denies of ever making a call, and there is no evidence of the same, and thus he is released from the prison. As Harlow was in jail, FBI suspect of him having a partner who kept Emily. As Emily tries to remember, she could only remember a masked face and name of Flas. This gave FBI a clue into one of Emily's old trafficking cases, where one of the main suspect, Robert, used to give his victims name of the Flas. They have also found some skin under the dead body's nail, and suspecting Robert to be involved, they run a DNA test, but are surprised to find that it is in fact Robert who died, and the skin under his nail is of Emily. At the same time, a witness approaches Boston PD and identifies Emily having an argument with a man on the marina, and as she goes through the photos, she identifies Robert to be that man. They now suspect Emily has staged the whole thing, including her abduction. Nick, not believing in the witness, investigates her and finds that she used to be a money launderer and an FBI agent helped her change her name. Meanwhile, Emily confronts Harlow, but he has already called the cops and they take her away, but Nick gets her out. Later that night, Harlow's body is found being stabbed in the back, and Boston PD suspects Emily to be involved. As Nick looks for the dirty fed, Emily reconnects with Flynn. Nick suspects Adam to be involved, and as he confronts him, he has all the right answers, and as Nick shares this information with Emily, she breaks into his house and finds a journal having drawings of a bleeding eye, and these are of the visions which Emily is having. Boston PD found a video of Emily leaving her apartment the night of Harlow's killing, and as Nick confronts her, she tells him she was watching him to look what life could have been for her, but Boston PD has issued a warrant against her, and Nick has to take her in. And in that emotional moment, they make out. But Emily leaves before Nick could arrest her. She abducts Adam and informs Nick that she needs to prove that she is not guilty before coming in. Emily interrogates Adam to why he abducted her, but he denies having any involvement. Adam finally admits that he sent the witness to give a false confirmation of seeing Emily, as he believes she is guilty, but he had no involvement in kidnapping her. Emily is still not convinced, as she has seen the bleeding eye drawing in his journal, and Emily has those visions in her mind. Adam tells her that when they were about to arrest Harlow, he overheard him talking to someone and asking them to meet at a bleeding eye, and it is a place, not a person. And as he looked for her for 6 years, he had those drawings in his journal. Emily is convinced that Adam might not be involved, and as she hears Gibbs and Nick approaching, she leaves, and as she leaves, Adam is shot dead and Nick and Gibbs are fired upon. Having this information, Emily visits her doctor and asks her to help her remember the place, as she thinks she has seen it as a kid, and Emily is finally able to figure out where the place is. As the FBI looks for her, the doctor thinks she might be having a split personality, where one of the personality is the killer while the other the investigator. Doctor advises them to look back into her childhood to know where she is going. Nick approaches her brother Jack to find more about her childhood and is able to figure out where she might be heading. As Emily reaches the place, she looks around and starts digging and finds a body buried. With authorities right behind her, Emily takes an implant from the body and runs. The body which they recovered has its eyelids missing, and it might be one of the first victims of the serial killer. Meanwhile, Emily breaks into his brother's house to use his medical connection to find who the pacemaker belongs to. But as she goes through his computer, she finds hidden folders with name of flowers on it, having videos of bondage and drowning. Thinking her brother might be involved, Emily follows the girl his brother was with and interrogates her. But things don't go as planned and Emily is shot in the process. Left with no options, Emily has to call his brother for help. Meanwhile, Boston PD has found hidden accounts and anonymous payments on his brother's laptop, and they are now suspecting Jack as he is the one who led them to that jungle. But Jack stitches up Emily and saves her life. And as she confronts him, Jack tells her that when she was away, he was in rehab and they mend fences. Jack helps Emily to locate who the pacemaker belongs to, and they find it belongs to Dr. Shin, one of the administrators of Emily's old orphanage. Emily traces her brother, who gives her the location of Dr. Shin's storage house. And as Emily goes through his stuff, she finds a tape. And she learns that Dr. Shin was conducting some sick experiment on kids, which simulated drowning in the same way she was. FBI is also able to discover the identity of Dr. Shin, which leads them to the same warehouse, and they also learn about the experiments. And as Nick returns home, he finds Alice and Flynn missing, and he suspects Emily to have abducted them. Jack is approached by a reporter who thinks Emily is innocent, and she wants to write her side of the story. But as Jack learns that she is the one who approached Emily in the hospital, he dismisses her. Knowing Flynn to be missing, Emily seeks her dad's help to locate one of the test subjects, as she believes the other subject B is the one responsible for everything. Her dad figures out that Charles is in a mental asylum, and Emily goes to get more information from him. Following the evidence, Nick and Gibbs are also able to locate Charles. And on the other hand, we see Flynn being subjected to the same experiment. Emily is able to get to Charles first, but before she could learn anything, Nick and Gibb also reach, and she has to leave. Emily returns to Dr. Shen's brother, and the aquarium gives her a clue, as she thinks it's the same company which provided the glass box in which she was kept, and she's able to trace the company and ask Jack to find who ordered the box and where it was delivered. Nick and Gibbs talk to Charles, and they were able to figure out where the experiments were done. At the same time, Jack, with the help of the reporter, figures out the location where the box was shipped and is surprised to learn that Emily is the one who ordered them. As Emily reaches the place, she finds a photo of the woods and she knows where it is. Nick and Gibbs miss Emily by moments, and Nick discovers the mask which Emily described and figures out that Harlow was not the one in charge. Emily finds the location and calls Nick and tells him to come alone, as the killer might be watching. As Emily looks, she is knocked unconscious, and when she wakes up, she finds Alice beside her. And the abductor tells Emily that as a kid, she switched her psychological profile. As a result, she was not experimented on, and it is revealed that it's none other than the reporter herself. She tells Emily that she is the one who killed Adam, but not Robert or Harlow. She also tells Emily that she is the one who killed Dr. Shin, and she holds Emily responsible for it. And this is why she kept Emily locked for 6 years, breaking her, since Dr. Shin experimented on her for 6 years. But when, even after all that conditioning, Emily didn't kill Alice, she had to improvise, and now she wants her to kill Alice in order to save Flynn. But Nick reaches on time, and they are able to save Flynn. Nick is still not sure of Emily, and as they try to get out, they are fired upon. Emily goes after her, while Nick, after getting Alice and Flynn to safety, gets back to help Emily. But he is shot, and Emily takes the reporter out, and she is cleared of all the charges. As the season ends, we see Emily enjoying Flynn's birthday, but she has a vision and sees herself killing Harlow.